Hello, so got a Roborock on my bench today. This is a S7 Max V or Max 5. I bought this dirt cheap because it doesn't turn on anymore. So when I got it, I did a hard factory reset. You hold in the home button and push the reset button. It sits here once. And still holding the home button until the Roborock tells you that it does a reset. Then you can let it go, and when it turns back on again, it's resetted. So I managed to turn it on, but the battery drains very fast. I got it to connect to my network. I got it to run a bit. So when I started the Roborock, I got error code 18, and that's something wrong with the suction motor or fan motor. So I have to take it apart and see if I find anything I can fix or a part that is broken. Supposedly the fan motor is a suspect here. So I wonder if something is shorted in the motor that's draining the battery very fast. I'm not gonna go in detail on how you take the Roborock apart. I will link a video that shows it very detailed, so you can follow that. So I'll fast forward a bit and I'll take it apart and we'll see inside the Roborock. So I've already taken out the water tank. Taken off the mopping plate and have taken out the dustbin. So I take out the brush under here. Okay, so the Roborock is taken apart. There is a couple of steps that you don't need to follow. And the one first step is this part here where the brush sits. You don't have to take this out. These two screws can be seated. And this part here where the mop sits, you don't need to take out if you don't need to change the mop unit. So for accessing the main board and the electronics here, you have to follow the other steps. So one of the problems I've got is the Wi-Fi connection is bad. And if you take a look at the circuit board here, you may be able to spot the problem. So the person that was inside here the last time did not connect the Wi-Fi antenna that should be connected here. It goes from, this is the antenna. And the cable should be connected here. And here is no cable. And I find the cable here. So hopefully I can reconnect it without having to take the board out. Looks like I have to loosen the board. to get the antenna cable out. So it was, according to the previous owner of this Roborock, it was Elkjøp that had taken it apart and said the unit was water damaged, so it did not or was not covered by the warranty anymore. So therefore he sold it for a cheap price. So it's a bit weird that Elkjøp did not put the antenna cable back into place and they took the unit apart. Looks like it shouldn't be. Yes, you got some brackets for the. Cable here. So you can see this slot should hold the cable into place. There. There, the antenna is back into place, so hopefully this helps me get some better Wi-Fi signals. Probably does. Okay, so to problem number two, water damage. Looks like it has been some water here. You can see some rust on the spring. But most likely, it's this fan motor that has gone kapoof or is broken. I'll take it apart and see. If there is something wrong with it. Because if you get water into the dustbin, it will go straight into the fan motor. Does not. Here you can see, here is a watermark. This is why the warranty didn't cover a new Roborock. This should be white, but as fast as it gets in contact with water, it gets red, and this is red. So they took this out and saw, aha. This unit is water damaged. And you get the error code 18, so I'll try to take the fan motor out. See if there is anything to fix. So before we take a look at the motor, you can see here it's burning marks. So the fan motor has probably shorted, and that's why it's draining the battery. So here is the fan motor. You can see the water has been here. But I can't see any burning marks on the motor or a circuit board. So maybe they have replaced the motor. Let's take this rubber off. It's always fun to investigate electronics. Something new to learn every day. See if the motor spins freely. It does. Okay, I will take this plate off. To see if something is shorted underneath the plate, steel plate. So the steel plate is stuck to the motor. We got a locking pin here. I'd rather not take the locking pin out, because I don't know if I'll be able to get it back into place. Got some circuit underneath the underneath here. So I'll see if I get this pin out without too much problem, and I'll be back. Okay, so I got the pin out and separated the fan from the board. Now you can take a look under a microscope, and I'll show you some of the damages. So this is the damage I can see on the board. And as you can see, the board has a waterproof layer on it. This blank stuff here, clear stuff. But I wonder if something has gone bad on the windings. So I'll try to clean it. And see if I find anything around here that can be fixed. If not, I'm gonna buy a new fan motor. So I've taken off some of the waterproofing or coating. These two legs are badly soldered. This resistor looks like I'll try to reflow it. But everything looks okay here. I just resolder these two and reflow the resistor. So let's check the windings. Try to get a good connection here. .78 ohms. Same on this one. Same on this one. So the windings looks like it's okay. Try to measure between the metal plate and see if, yeah, sixty-five ohms between the windings and the metal plate. I think that's not right. Okay, so update. The fan motor or suction motor is dead. So I have ordered a new one. That's on its way. So mounting that will be in part two. Sadly, I lost some recordings I have done because I took this main board out and checked the underside, and it had been water underneath the board. The sticker on the top says no water has been there, but underneath there had been some water. So there was some corrosion on a resistor in the battery circuit. I think it's the circuit that senses the voltage on the battery. So that's why I did get the empty battery all the time. Indication for that, because when I changed the resistor that was gone bad and cleaned the board up and started the RoboRock again, then it showed me full battery and the Wi-Fi connection is very good again. So attaching the antenna cable helped a lot. That's not weird. So yeah, I fixed the battery issue. I fixed the antenna Wi-Fi issue. New motor on its way. And sorry for I have lost the recordings of the underside of the board. But it was just a small resistor change. Some micro soldering. So yeah, when I get the fan motor, see you in part two. Bye.